So happy Sunday. Today, I'm going to take you outside. Why? Because it's really cold. 26 degrees Fahrenheit. Dew point, 21.9. Feels like 26.8 degrees. Look what's going on out here. Lots of snow. Great opportunity to take you outside and show you what the difference is when your hives face south versus north. And this is my Flir C2 getting charged up. I'm going to take it out there. It has two lenses on it. One will give me the physical outline like a regular camera. And the other is the thermal. That's the one down at the low part there. Has its own battery. You have to charge it up, get it out there. Several years old. Don't even know if those are available for purchase anymore. That is the way to be academy building. Nice and cold in there. South wall, south facing window, so it warms up nice too. Long Langstroth hive. We're going to look at all of these. Now in this apiary, it's shaped like a horseshoe. That way I have landing boards facing multiple directions. And we're going to see a dramatic difference here. All of these hives face south. Look what's going on. Look at the landing boards. Nice and clear, every one of them. They have hive visors, even the nucleus hives, all the way at the end. Very warm south-facing walls, by the way, and we're going to take thermal shots of that. The bees have been coming out, doing tiny cleansing flights and landing in the snow. There are hive visors, and that's why we see snow built up on those, because there's nothing warm underneath of them. And they all have insulated covers, and the snow builds up on the top of that. Just like when you look at the roof of a house that's well insulated, the snow does not melt off on a hot day. Even when it's insulated well, if it's not insulated well, the snow will just melt off and drip down. We're going to do thermal scans of all of these. This is a hive gate on this one. All of the hives, I can tell you ahead of time, are alive. And they're all off the ground. We do have skunks visiting, even in wintertime. But look at the thermals here. Be smart, insulated inner cover, the medium super. Look at the surface temperature. That target that's in the middle gives us a temperature that you see on the top left there, all the way up into the 90s. Because it's sunny, even though it's really cold outside. Sun makes a difference. Melts all the snow off the landing board. Here's the entrance, nice and clear. If I were on vacation, I wouldn't have to worry about clearing snow off of this at all. And there's the hive visor, plenty of snow on that. And here's the hive next to it. There's the medium box, which was full of honey going into fall. And look, the face of it goes up into the 80s. Now I have to look at the shaded side to see if there's a difference as I scan from top to bottom. And there was, if you notice, that top medium was up in the 50s. This lower side reads into the 40s. And that lets me know I have bees alive in there, but I already knew that. Thermals reinforce what we already know if we've seen bees flying. And if you get your ear down next to the entrance, you'll hear them lightly humming inside. So here again, medium super, face temperature, 90 some degrees and even up in the super. So facing south, the landing board or entrance side of your hive is nice and hot. Of course, if the landing boards are facing north, the hot side would be the back of your hive. And now here we are. These are the north-facing beehives, and they're in the shadow also of a spruce tree. And we're going to do thermals on those. Look at the shaded side, 20s to 30s. But the good news is, no matter what the accuracy of the Flir C2 is, all I'm looking for is a variance in the temperature as I scan up and down the hives. Because even on the shaded side, like this nucleus right here, 34, 35, then we drop down, it's in the 20s. So that lets me know that they're already up into that upper box. It has a nice 2-inch thick rigid foam board cap over it, and that's why it reads 16 and 15 degrees up there. And the cluster's in there. They're alive. No supplemental feed on that hive, by the way. Now we're looking at this one over here. Now this is my standard configuration. Deep box, medium honey super, insulated inner cover, feeder shim on top. And then a B-Max polystyrene cover on top of that. That's why snow sits on top of all of these. But look at the landing boards, every one of them covered in snow. If they all faced south, none of these landing boards would have snow on them. That's a motion sensor alarm up there. And again, the configuration, insulated inner cover. Double deeps on this one because it's an 8 deep frame box. Flow hive base, landing boards covered. And we just scan for thermals to see if there's any variance as we go from the high to the down and see what's underneath the hive visor. We're in the 30s down there on the shaded side. That's a sign of life. Because remember, it's reading the surface temperature. Inside the hive, of course, if it's reading 30 or 40 or something like that, the cluster is much warmer inside the hive. Some people have asked if this time of year I thought that brood would be building up inside these hives, and I would have to say that it is. Some of the bees were flying out doing cleansing flights. Not many. You look for them in the snow. And it was great to see that they were staying in. Now the question is, do those that are facing south have more cleansing flights than those with the landing boards facing north? And they do. That's evidenced by the bees that we see at the entrances and the bees that we see in the snow out in front of your hive. Again, this is a nucleus box, 5 deep frames over 5 deep frames, and the cluster is up in the second box. And we've got plenty of time still. Winter ahead. Look at the landing board covered in snow. Deep box, and we go from 32 to 34. So any elevation in temperatures we go up, evidence of life. Medium honey super there was wall-to-wall honey going into winter, and then again, the insulated inner cover and a feeder shim. Hive alive fondant is on each of these, except the nucleus hives. No fondant on that. And this, of course, is what it looks like without the thermal camera in the way. Lots of snow built up. Tiny entrance on that. If we didn't have thermals right now, that hive looks dead. But it's not. Here we are, this Apame hive, sitting on a wooden slatted rack and a standard wooden bottom board. Because we replaced some damaged woodenware with that. They're still alive, by the way. We're just showing the dramatic difference in landing board snow cover. And then we get the thermals here. When you have an insulated hive like an Apame, you're almost wasting your time doing surface thermal readings on it. But look, it did go up to 30. Now, I can't tell. I don't have the history with these hives. I don't know if that means that that is radiating through the insulated hive itself. I was also looking for those indents to see if they were showing leaks of warmth, and I really haven't seen it. Now, I expected, just looking at the way it's made, that the thinner walls where the handles are or where the indents are in the front there, that I would see some heat leaking through there. The lighter the color that you're looking at on the scan, the warmer the temperature. And I did not notice heat leaks. Interesting. And now you can see how it's configured. And then this is a flow hive bottom, medium super. It's all in the shade though. So even though this is facing south, it didn't benefit from the sun because the trees are in the way. So we get up here and we'll scan the temperature. So if we look at the top left there, 23.9, 19. And then you get at the landing board, which I will scrape off later. Now we jump, look, 38 degrees, 37, 39, 41. This starts to show me where the cluster is. So it looks like the cluster begins at the bottom of that what was a full medium honey super. Then the insulated Bee Smart Designs inner cover. There is Hive Life fondant on this, and then the top box is a feeder shim. And the polystyrene cover on top, and of course it's snow covered. So this also demonstrates what happens if you put your hives in the shade. So the best scenario if you're in a northern climate, south facing landing boards in full sun when the sun is in the low south, as it is all through winter. Here we are, shows it without the thermal camera, and everything's nice and snow covered. As I mentioned before, I do come back through and scrape off the entrances with my clean out tool, the long skinny blue one that we've all seen. But to hear again on this one, look at that, 36 in the shade. So here, not only is there a good sized cluster in there, but they're still low, which means they have lots of honey above them and they're making a tiny dent on the Hive Alive fondant. I have not had to replace a single pack of Hive Alive fondant yet this year. So on the next warm day, of course, we'll pop the covers and look at the fondant progress. But right now, because it is so cold, we're not opening anything. We're just doing surface thermals. And I wanted to share with you what it means when you have landing boards facing south or south by southeast. And this is the Lands hive, super insulated, lots of snow on it, no surprise. The long Langstroth hive here, it does have double bubble on the top now. So it's sealed up nice. That's the way to be academy building. And I'm showing you the row of windows along the roof up there, bringing lots of sun and heat into this building because that long wall faces south. So we're going to take a look at the hot side of this hive too, but I can tell you ahead of time, this hive is alive. Look at the scan here. So towards the left, even on the shaded side, we can see that the temperature does go up. It's at 44, 38, 47, 49, 50. So even if this is inaccurate, the increase in temperature as we scan across helps us locate where the cluster is inside the long Langstroth. So these guys have plenty of honey left in this hive, and adding insulation to it definitely boosted them. And again, we're looking at the north side of it, so the entrance is on the south side. We'll take a look at that in a minute. So here they are, and there's activity at the entrance. And it looks like they've done some cleaning out too, because that's a worker. It looks like they uncapped it and pulled it out in its pupa phase. Now the thing is, I don't know if that bee has been laying there for several weeks or if they just dragged it out, but the bee that's coming out to look at it looks pretty healthy to me. I also don't see a bunch of dysentery on the front of it, and this side of this hive is nice and hot. Here we are at the lay-in's hive, also alive. No supplemental feeding on this hive at all. They have plenty of honey and capped resources in the hive on those nice deep frames, so we're testing that out this year. Here's another one, another lay-ins. It's also insulated, so surface thermals are kind of worthless to me, but we did see bees moving around at the entrance, so signs of life. You can also put your ear right up to the entrance. You don't have to knock on it, and you will hear a tiny whir. So if your hearing is really good, you can just listen at the entrances and know that your bees are alive. And they're not circulating much air. So I think we're in good shape for both the lay-ins and the long lang. And this lower field, every one of the hives, their entrances are facing south. Every one of these hives has live bees in it. So we have deep brood box there and a medium super. We have double deeps at the lower one. This one here is a deep with a medium. The only reason I leave them with double deeps going into winter is because the colony was too populated for me to pack it down to a deep and a medium. Here we get the thermals again, and we're just looking for the difference. 48 degrees, drops to 44, 43, so they're up at the bottom of this medium super here. Not bad at all. So signs of life, that's all we needed to know. There's the feeder shim, 52, but remember it's being warmed on the left side there by the sun. Drops to 48 there. So if they got up into that feeder shim to feed on the fondant, it's actually warmer than it is, based on the surface temperature, of course, warmer than it is on the lower boxes. So they would be encouraged to go up there and get their resources. But as we scan slowly up and look for the temperature increase, it'll show us right here, 45, where the cluster begins. So I think we're in good shape on all of these boxes. Here we are, January the 15th. Plenty of winter yet to go, but it was a nice day to come out and do this. No wind, by the way. So great. Other than the noise of that snowmobile, I think we're okay out here. Landing boards facing south will be cleared by the sun. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this entertaining and informative.